हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू एसएसटी क्लास चैप्टर नंबर 3 रोटेशन एंड रेवोल्यूशन फॉर क्लास 5th पार्ट 4। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट रोटेशन, व्हाट इज रोटेशन एंड व्हाट इज रेवोल्यूशन, and also we have learnt in previous class day and night, how occurred that day and night. And today's topic is the revolution of the earth. See a student, revolution revolution of the earth. See student, revolution of the earth, the earth rotates orbit around the sun. The earth rotates orbit around the sun. It has taken the time 365 days and 1/4. So 1/4 means 365 days and 6 hours, and these extra days, these number of days, extra days adding in the month of February. So after the four years, we are seeing here 366 days, means in February month, after the 4 years, we are seeing the 29 days. So it is calling that leap year. So it is called that what? Leap year. So you know straight. So it is known as revolution. So this revolution of the earth, once again I repeating, revolution means what? The earth rotates, otherwise the earth orbit around the sun is known as revolution. When the earth orbit around the sun, it has taken the time 365 days and 6 hours. So these remaining extra time, extra date we are adding in the month of February. In the month of February, every fourth year, in the month of February, 29 days are coming. Then in that year, 366 days is called leap year. Understood? Okay, it is about revolution of the earth. So next you see a student. So next concept is the seasons of the earth. Seasons of the earth. So you know that seasons, summer, winter, autumn and spring. So these are 4 seasons are there on the earth. First First, when summer season. Second, when winter season. Third, when autumn season. And fourth, when spring season. See here, student. These seasons, when the we are see him. You can see here. So this is the sun, and earth rotates, means earth orbit around the sun. Okay, and here I mentioned northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere, and here is also the northern hemisphere and it is southern hemisphere, and you can see here northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Here also mention I northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. See student, the sun rays away means the sun rays falling towards the earth face. Which face is that? Means earth face. So see here, you can see here in the northern hemisphere, this part is a northern hemisphere. You can also see here, this part is a northern hemisphere. When earth is orbit around the sun, when it comes here, the northern hemisphere's towards to the sun, the means the earth face here, northern hemisphere's towards to the sun, the sun rays are falling on that part, and in that time, so these northern hemispheres receives the more sun rays. Northern hemisphere receives more sun rays, and see here, in the longest days are they here, 21st June, beginning of that summer days. In that time, in the northern hemisphere, longest days means see here student, some northern hemisphere receives more sun rays and southern hemisphere receives less sun rays. So here occurred winter season. See a student. So northern hemisphere leans towards to the sun here. This northern hemisphere is leans towards to the sun, and southern hemisphere. So this part is what? Southern hemisphere. So this part is away from the sun. Away from the sun, and then the northern hemisphere receives more sun rays. And see here, when northern hemisphere receiving more sun rays, here occurring summer season. And next you can see here student, and afterwards the southern hemisphere is receives less sun rays here. See here, you can see here, southern hemisphere receives less sun rays. This part is occurred winter season. Okay, and you can see here the longest day in the northern hemisphere. The longest day in the northern hemisphere is the 21st June. Longest day is this is northern hemisphere, and it is the 21st June. It's the beginning of summer. Otherwise, it is a summer solstice. Solstice means what? You know that the sun receives the minimum or maximum sun rays. Okay. And see here, in 21st June, beginning of summer here. And like this, similarly that when the northern hemisphere leans away from the sun, okay, and see here, it is southern hemisphere, oppose this, northern hemisphere, and here southern hemisphere, and it is northern hemisphere. Similarly here, in the northern hemisphere leans away from the sun, and southern hemisphere leans towards to the sun, and then southern hemisphere receives more sun rays. Southern hemisphere receives more sun rays. Okay, and here we can feel that winter season, and southern hemisphere occurs in summer season, and it's a summer season, and it is a shortest day in the northern hemisphere. Shortest day in the northern hemisphere is 22nd December. It is the beginning of winter. It is a winter solstice. Okay, student. And next you can see here, at the again revolution of Earth. It came here. Revolution of Earth. The sun shines twice directly over the equator. So it's a shining towards to the equator. Okay, so it is during equinox. The sunshine, it's working that twicely, means it shines towards to the equator, and then here equal days and equal nights are occurring here. And equinoxes occur 21st March and 23rd March. 21st March and 23rd March. 23rd September here occur equinox. Okay, means equal days and equal nights. See, student. So you know here. So this is about seasons of the Earth. So once again explaining this. So it is the sun, the Earth revolving around the sun, and when it's revolving around the sun, some seasons are changing on the Earth surface. You can see here. So first I explained here. So it's a northern hemisphere. It's a southern hemisphere. So this part is also northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. When the Earth face towards to the northern hemisphere, the Earth rays are falling to the northern hemisphere, means Earth face towards to the Earth here. Here we are feeling summer season, and southern hemisphere, it is away from the sun. In this southern hemisphere occurs here winter season. It occurs here winter season. Okay. And in this time, the longest day is the 21st June. It's the beginning of summer. And afterwards, again, it's revolving. Revolving the Earth. See here. So this part is changes that, means the Earth rotates on its axis. Okay. And some directions are changing here. Then this face is now southern hemisphere. This face is now southern hemisphere towards to the sun. And northern hemisphere away from the sun. And southern hemisphere here occurred So shortest days here occur means in that time in southern hemisphere occur summer days, and shortest days means it's a southern hemisphere. The shortest day in the northern hemisphere, shortest day is the northern hemisphere is 22nd December, beginning of winter days. So it is we calling this winter solstice. And you can see here student, when the sun rays falling towards to the equator, so twicely, so it's falling towards to the equator, here occurs equal days and equal nights. Means we are feeling here 21st March and 23rd September, these are the equal days and equal nights. Here seasons occurred in spring season, and in 23rd September it's the beginning of autumn season. It is the 21st March beginning of spring season and 23rd September beginning of autumn season. So these are the four seasons. Okay student, so here completed your chapter number 3, rotation and revolution. It's a part 4 also completed here. So what you have learnt in today's part, so you have learnt in today's part about revolution, and also you have learnt seasons of the earth. There are four seasons of earth: summer, winter, autumn and spring. So you have to draw like this diagram and make the points. After completing your homework, you send it my WhatsApp number. And so next part I am continuing in next class. Thank you.